press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, how are you all? I think you are all fine. Okay, what we learned in the previous class, we learned the properties of multiplication for multiplication. Okay, under multiplication for integers, and we also learned some easier methods to multiply the given numbers. We use some patterns. Okay, so in this class, we are going to solve some example problems with the exercise problems. Okay, the second example is given that find each of the following products. Okay, so here we can make we can group the given numbers for our convenience, otherwise we can multiply the given numbers one after the other, but we should make it easy. Okay, the first one is given is minus 18 into minus 10 into 9. What's the easy way? Then we can first multiply 18 with 10, otherwise we can multiply 10 with 9, grouping the numbers, any two numbers. Okay, so first multiply, I multiply 18 with minus 18 into minus 10, then I multiply the product of time product with 9. Okay, so minus into minus is plus. 18 tens are 180. 18 tens are 180. I got plus 180, and now we have to multiply it with 9. Okay, so 18 nines are, if then I can take the within the bracket, plus 180 into 9. 18 nines are 162, or 9 zeros are 0, 9 18s are 162. The answer is plus 1620. Okay, go to second one. It's minus 20 into minus 2 into minus 5 into 7. Okay, make any two numbers, take any two numbers in a group. If you take minus 20 and minus 2, it's okay, or minus 2 and 7, it's okay, 20 and 5, it's also okay, but you should feel it's easier, it is easy to multiply. Okay, what we can take, like this, 20 into 5, 7 into 2. Okay, okay, so I take minus 20 into minus 5 in one group, then I multiply the obtained product with this group, that is minus 2 into 7. Okay, then minus into minus is plus. 2 5s are 10, or 20 5s are 100. We got plus 100 here, and multiply this with minus into plus is minus. 2 7s are 14. We got minus 14. It's easy to multiply with 100. 14 1s are 14. Plus into minus is minus. 14 1s are 14. Then we can put zeros here. It's minus 1400. Minus 1400. Okay, go to third one. So third one is minus 1 into minus 5 into minus 4 into minus 6. Any numbers you make it group, nothing is by grouping, it doesn't depend on the grouping. The product doesn't depend on the group. Okay, so minus into minus. Minus 1 into minus 5. I take these two numbers into minus 4 into minus 6. Okay, so minus into minus is plus. 1 into 5 is 5. We got plus 5. Then multiply this with minus into minus is plus. 4, 6 are 24. Okay, so 24 5s are, then 5 4s are, plus into plus is plus. 5 4s are 20 to remain, to carry. 2, 5 2s are 10 plus 2 is 12. So it's plus 120. Okay, the third one is, third example given is, verify minus 30 into, in bracket they have given 13 plus of minus 3, that's equal to minus 30 into 13 plus of minus 30 into minus 3. Okay, so what's the property used here? They used distributive property upon addition. Okay, so then, okay, now here when they ask to verify, we have to take left hand side and both the that is the right hand side. Okay, consider LHS here. LHS is equal to, it's minus 30 into 13 plus of minus 3. First find the product of this side. Is it's equal to minus 30 into 13. Minus 30 into 13 plus minus 30 into minus 3. Okay, that is equal to, so minus into plus is minus. 13 3s are 39. It's minus 390. Okay, put it in a bracket. Plus minus into minus is plus. 3 3s are 9. It's 90. Okay, so it's plus into minus is minus 390. Take out 90 from the bracket. Plus into plus is plus 90. What we get? So minus 390 plus 90 is minus 300. LHS is equal to 300. Okay, then go to RHS. In RHS we have, what we have, we have to write here. RHS is equal to, it's minus 30 into 13 plus minus 30 into minus 3. Okay, then minus into plus is minus. 13 3s are 39. It's 3 minus 390. Okay, put it in a bracket. Plus, so minus into minus is plus. 3 33s are 90. The what we did here, it's same as like that. It's minus 390 plus into plus is plus. It's 90. Okay, what we got? 300 minus 300. What about LHS and RHS? Both are same. Here, LHS is equal to RHS. Hence, verified. They asked to verify taking LHS and taking RHS. We should compare both of them. Both are same if they are both If LHS and RHS are same, then we can write that verified. Therefore, right, you can write, therefore, minus 30 into 13 plus of minus 3 is equal to minus 30 into 13 plus minus 30 into minus 3. So like this, hence verified. Therefore, this is equal to this. We have to write like this. Okay, let's move to the next one. Next example. Okay, I read the question. Listen to me. In a class test containing 15 questions, 4 marks are given for every correct answer and minus 2 marks are given for every incorrect answer. The first question is, Gurupreet attempts all questions but only 9 of her answers are correct. What is her total score? This is the first question. One of her friends gets only 5 answers correct. What will be her score? Okay, her friend, okay. I explain the question here. One test is conducted for Gurupreet and whole class. So, it contained 15 questions. Okay, then the 4 marks are given for the correct answers and minus 2 marks are given for the incorrect answer. And Gurupreet, she attended all the questions, 15 questions, but she gave correct answers for 9 questions. And what are the remaining? Remaining 6 are, she gave incorrect answers for 6 questions. And 15 minus 9 is 6 questions. Okay, for 6 questions she gave incorrect answers. And one of her friends gets only 5 answers. Okay, and her friend, she answered for 5 questions and they are asking to find the total score of Gurupreet and total score that is scored by her friend. Okay. Okay. Marks given for one. This is the fourth question and answer for that. Fourth example. Marks given for one correct answer. Is equal to 4. Okay. Then Gurupreet, she gave correct answers for 9 questions. Then what we can write? Marks given for 9 correct answers is equal to, therefore, marks given for 9 correct answers is equal to 4 into 9 is equal to 36 marks. 36 marks is given to Gurupreet, but it's not her score because she answered correctly for 9 questions and gave incorrect answers for 6 questions. Okay, then marks given for 1 incorrect answer is equal to minus 2. Therefore, marks given for 6 incorrect. How we get 6? 15 minus 9. We have to subtract 9 from 15. 6, that is 15 minus, that is 15, no, don't write here. We can understand how we got 6. 6, incorrect. Answers is equal to minus 2 into 6, that is equal to minus into plus is minus 2, 6 is 12. It's minus 12. Therefore, Guru preaches total score is equal to, we have to subtract because this is the score for 9 correct answers and this is the score for 6 incorrect answers. Okay, to find the actual score we have to subtract 12 from 36. Okay, that is equal to 36. We have to add these two plus of minus 12. So total score is equal to, we have to add both these, 36 plus minus 12, that is equal to 36 plus into minus is minus 12, that is equal to, so 6 minus 2 is 4 and 3 minus 1 is 2. Gurupreet's total score is 24. And now we have to, this is for first one, and for second one we have to consider here marks given for one correct answer. Same steps we have to correct. Answer is equal to 4. This is of a friend. Okay, marks given for. So for how many questions she gave correct answers? For 5 questions. For 5 correct answers is equal to 4 into 5, that is equal to 20. For correct answers she scored 20 marks. Marks given for one incorrect answer is equal to minus 2. So then marks given for how many incorrect answers she gave, for how many questions she gave incorrect answers, she gave for 15 minus 5 is 10. Marks given for marks given for 10 incorrect answers is equal to, so minus 2 into 10, that is equal to minus into plus is minus, 2 tens are 20. She got minus 20. To find the real score we have to add both of these scores. Therefore her friend her friend's score is equal to 20 plus of minus 20, that is equal to 20 plus into minus is minus, plus into minus is minus 20, 0. She got 0 score. Okay, this is check out. Okay, then move to fifth one. So look into the question, the fifth question, what they have given. Fifth question is, I read the question. the fifth question. Suppose we represent the distance above the ground by a positive integer and that below the ground by a negative integer, then answer the following. There are two questions, one and two. First one is, an elevator descends into a mine shaft at the rate of 5 meters per minute. What will be its position after 1 hour? Then the second one is, if it begins to descend from 15 meters above the ground level, what will be its position after 45 minutes? Okay. In mine shaft, shaft means a narrow place. So for mining, it is in below the ground level. Okay. An elevator descends. Elevator descends means it goes into the ground, into a mine shaft at the rate of 5 meter per minute. Per minute it goes 5 meter. Then what they are asking is, what will be its position after 1 hour? Okay. 1 hour means it's 60 minute. It's 60 minute. Yes. Then how can we write the solution for the first one is, since elevator is going down, in the first they have given that, so considering the position of the elevator under the ground level, that is considered as negative integer, and above the ground level it is considered as positive integer. Okay. Since the elevator is going down, the distance covered by, since the elevator is going down, the distance covered by it will be represented by a negative integer. Since the elevator is going down, the distance covered by it is represented by a negative integer. Okay. Then change in position of the elevator in 1 minute. In 1 minute, it goes 5 meters per a minute. In 1 minute is equal to minus 5 meter, because it's going down below the ground level, so that it's considered by minus. It's represented by minus 5. Okay. Therefore, position of the elevator after 1 hour is equal to, that is 60, after 60 minutes is equal to minus 5 into 60, that is equal to minus into plus is minus. It's 35, 6 are 30, it's minus 300 meter. It goes in 1 hour, it goes 300 meters down. Okay. Then the solution for second one is, they're asking that if it begins to descend from 15 meter above the ground level, if it starts 15 meters above the ground level and after 45 minutes, what will be the position of the elevator? Okay. Change in position of the, change in position of the elevator in 45 minutes is equal to, so it's 5 meter per minute into 45 minutes, that is equal to minus into plus is minus, then 5 5s are 25, keep 2, 5 4s are 20 plus 2, 22, it's minus 225 meters, so the final position, so that the final position of the elevator is equal to, so I do here, is equal to, because it started from 15 meter above the ground level and we calculated here for 45 minutes with 5 meter per meter, and we have to add both of these, minus 225 meter plus of 15 meter, that is equal to, so here we have to subtract, here we have to subtract 225, minus 225 plus 15 is minus 210 meter. After 45 minutes, it reaches 210 meters below the ground level. Okay, let's go to exercise. Exercise problems, so they are very easy. You can do it yourself. It's the drilling work for you. Multiplying negative and positive numbers, it makes perfect. Okay. Then exercise 1.3. So in that first main, we have find each of the following products. Find each of the following products. In that first one, it's very easy, 3 into minus 1. What you get? 3 into minus 1. First, multiply the sign. So, you should very careful about the sign. Okay? Then, 3 into minus 1, that is equal to plus into minus is minus. 3 1s are 3. Answer is minus 3. Go to B, you do it yourself, minus 1 into 225, you do it yourself, minus 1 into 225, so minus into plus is minus, it's a multiplication identity for integers, plus 1 is multiplication, it's a identity, multiplication identity, here it's not, sorry for that, so minus 1 into 225 is minus 225. C is minus 21 into minus 30, minus 21 into minus 30, So first multiply the sign minus into minus plus, so keep 0 as it is, multiply 21 by 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Okay, D is minus 316 into minus 1. Okay, multiply the negative sign, minus into minus is plus, then when we multiply any number with 1, we get the same number, then minus into minus is plus, 316, 1s are 316. Go to E, it's minus 15 into 0 into minus 18. Okay, so think we have 0 in between these two numbers. When we multiply any number with 0, we get 0 only. Then you don't multiply 15 and 18 here. It's because it's waste of time. It have 0 in between those two numbers. Multiplying with 0, we get 0 only. Okay, go to F, it's minus 12 into minus 11 into 10. Okay, make it easier. How will you multiply? So multiply 12 with 11, it's okay. 12 with 10, it's also okay. 11 with 10, it's also okay. Then make it easier. How can we make? Answer is multiply minus 12 and into 10, then multiply it with minus 11. So minus into plus is plus, 12 tens are 120. Sorry, here it's minus. Minus 120 into minus 11. So minus into minus is plus, 11 zeros are 0, 11 twos are 22, keep 2. 11 ones are 11 plus 2 is 13. It's 1320. Okay. Go to G. Take G. 9 into minus 3 into minus 6. Here also, whatever the, how can you group the number? You can make it group. Okay. So 9 into 3, you get number, then multiply that product with minus 6. Be careful about the sign, negative sign. H1, that is minus 18 into minus 5 into minus 4. Okay, here, so you multiply with any number, you group with any number, 18 into 5. Are 18 into 4, 5 into 4, 4 into 18, anything that you can. H. I, so you do it yourself, I don't do, so you do it yourself, because these are very easy. This is only simple multiplication. Okay, I minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 into 4. Okay, so you make group here, minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 into 4. Okay, then minus into minus is plus, 1 twos are 2 into, put it in a bracket here, minus into plus is minus, 3 fours are 12. Again, plus into minus is minus, 12 twos are 24. We get minus 24 here. Okay. J, you do it yourself. Minus 3 into minus 6 into minus 2 into minus 1. Okay. So take down all these problems. Do it yourself. Okay. Go to second one. I do one problem. I solve one problem for you and another problem. You do it yourself. It makes perfect. Verify. I shown you in example problems. Verify the following. They asked to verify. Then how can we take, how can we verify? We should take here given equation as a left hand side and right hand side. First we have to check, first we have to multiply for the LHS, and afterwards we have to multiply the numbers in right hand side. Then we have to compare the answers that is in LHS and RHS. Okay, the first one is A, 18 into 7 plus minus 3, that is equal to 18 into 7 plus 18 into minus 3. So what's the property used here? It's used, this is distributive property. Distributive. Okay. So answer given is 18 into, okay. Then consider LHS. Here LHS is 18 into 7 plus of minus 3. Okay. 18 into 7 plus into minus is minus 3. Okay, that is equal to 18 into 7 minus 3 is plus into minus is minus 3, 4, okay. And 18 4s are 72, okay. Go to RHS. Here, take RHS. RHS is equal to 18 into 7 plus 18 into minus 3, okay. Then that is equal to 126 plus 126 plus 18 plus into minus is 54, that is equal to 126 plus into minus is minus 54, that is equal to 4 minus 2, 6 minus 4 is 2, and 12 minus it is 72. Here LHS is equal to RHS, hence verified. Therefore, so write down once again, 12 into 7 plus of minus 3, that is equal to 18 into 7 plus 18 into minus 3, okay. And take down the second one. This is for your homework. So do it in your homework. Minus 21, I write here, second one. So take down this, minus 21 into minus 4 plus of minus 6, that is equal to minus 21 into minus 4, okay, minus 4 plus of minus 21 into minus 6. Otherwise, write here. So sorry. Okay, finish this. Okay, I write here only. I write here the second one. Second one, you do it yourself. You do it yourself. B1 minus 21 into minus 4 plus of minus 6, that is equal to minus 21 into minus 4 plus minus 21 into minus 6. Okay, and the third main is like this. This is homework. For any integer A, what is minus 1 into A equal to? What we get when we multiply any integer with my negative number, that is the given integer A is a positive integer, and we have to, here they multiplied with minus 1, then they are multiplying with a negative integer, then what we get? Negative integer only. But here they have given minus 1. When we multiply any integer with minus 1, what we get? We get that number only with negative sign. That number, the given number with negative sign, okay? Then how can we write this? For any integer A, so like this, for any integer A, minus 1 into A is always equal to minus A. Okay, in that second one is, given second one is, this is the first one, and the second one is, determine the integer whose product with, again they given the same as above, minus 1 is. They are asking to multiply with different numbers with 22. What we get? What will we get? We get minus, when we multiply 22 with minus 1, we get minus 22. Okay, you do it yourself. I did for you. The first one I did for you. And you do this by 237 and 0. When we multiply any number with 0, what we get? We get 0 only. Okay. So, check out the problems. Okay. Let's finish for this class. In the next class, we move with the, or we solve the next mains, and we move to the next topic. Okay. Thank you.